Hey everybody, it's Aaron from Corlane Sporting Goods, and we're at Rod's private test facility with Brent McNamee, one of our good customers, gonna do break in his Rocky Mountain rifle with a Husqvarna scope. So Rod, tell us what we're doing here.
So here's a 7mm Magnum custom rifle we built Brent last year, I guess. And Brent is now flown in. He's doing an Alberta sheep hunt tomorrow. So we've got here set up on the hill, we'll show you in a minute. We've got some gongs set up from 375 to about 600 yards. We've got a custom turret built for this scope, and we're gonna try some long range shots on some metallic life-size animals. Should be fun. Then Brent's gonna go and tear down a big ram. It'll be an awesome hunt.
Looking forward to it. Rod, can you maybe just give me a quick refresher on windage and adjustments with this turret for this?
So what we've got today, I've got a wind meter out here. It's not highly windy. It's from zero to about 7 mile an hour. Right now we're at zero. But when those gusts come up and they're about 7 miles an hour, we've got you set at 400 yards here, or 375. The hash mark up here indicates that you hold 2 minutes of wind based upon a 10 mile an hour wind speed. Again, right now we're zero. So if you took a shot right now, we don't have our hearing and eye pro on yet, but when we do, we'll check the wind speed again and do some calculating so you can adjust for that wind. Yeah, right now we're at about 4 mile an hour, 6 mile an hour now. So we'll figure this out, but we'll probably have you hold 1 minute of wind upwind, roughly, based upon this current wind speed. We'll check it again in a minute. But yeah, we'll get you all set up and we'll poke a coyote gong out there at 375 yards, and then we'll move up to about 600.
Okay, looking forward to it.
Okay.
Walk me through your mental process when, let's say, you're pulling up on a sheep. So first thing is, okay, let's say I range it for you, tell you the range, first adjustment's this,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Is your second adjustment your parallax?
Yeah, do you focus? Get your parallax set.
And then third would be windage?
Start dealing with the wind and the angle.
Okay, now let's talk about angles.
Well, there's a couple ways to figure it out. These Swarovski binoculars, which is what you have?
Yeah.
If you were to say, pick a target off at the top of that hill,
yeah.
So I'll just quickly look and it says that it is 671 yards.
So there's the line of sight distance.
Yeah, that's the line of sight, 671 yards. But the angle, this binocular is correcting it to 660. So that's only a 13 yard correction. That's not a lot. That's not a lot of angle what you're looking at there.
Right.
But you know, we've taken shots where you're having to make 50 and 75 and 100 yard adjustments when you're...
So rule of thumb though, if you're shooting on a decline versus shooting on an incline, like that'll give you the actual yardage adjustment.
Yeah.
But you're aiming higher or aiming lower? What's the adjustment?
Whether your target is uphill or downhill,
yeah,
you will need to shoot low.
Yeah, because that was giving you a lower reading than the line of sight.
Yeah. And the steeper the angle, the more you're going to have to correct.
Whether you're sport shooting or in a hunting situation, having a spotter with a spotting scope that can kind of watch that bullet go, watch that vapor trail, and even watch the point of impact, can then provide some additional coaching if you did miss, if you're left or right, low or high.
Yeah, spotter is very helpful. You can see, you don't even have to really see the bullet strike the ground out by the target. You can watch the vapor trail and make the correction with the second shot if you've missed the first one. It's quite visible on a day like this with the sun behind us. I think we'll see it really well.
Now these coyote sheep gongs aren't going to run away if I miss?
Let's hope not. If they do, I'm going to be shocked.
Okay.
I'm going to have to get a refund.
All right, Brent, you'll want to dial up to about 385 yards.
Okay.
And I will get back with the spotting scope.
Sounds good.
Going hot, guys.
Going hot.
Smashed it. Second shot. Going hot.
Very nice, very nice.
Awesome, that gun shoots great.
Yeah. I love the Husqvarna. You know, there's you're not doing any vertical holdover. You're just adjusting right to the range you want. And
yeah.
Simplifies it, you know.
Yeah, you can make a good, accurate, ethical shot at some pretty amazing ranges. So yeah, let's try out that sheepdog up around 600 there. Okay, Brent, give it about a minute to the left.
Going hot.
Going hot. Dead on.
Very nice. Shoot it again. Going hot.
Awesome.
That is just what works.
Okay. So 610 yard, 8-inch target up there. You hit it about 3 inches apart by the looks of it. So that's pretty wicked shooting. And for your bighorn hunt, yeah, you're dialed in nice there.
Well, I think the key thing, like anything else, practice makes perfect. If you can get a chance to spend some time out on the range and get to know your firearm, get to know what it's capable of, and be able to adjust for different weather conditions, you know, then it'll give you more confidence when you're out in the field.
Agreed. Absolutely. Well, good work. It looks like you've got this thing dialed in nicely. I hope to see some bighorn pictures.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, awesome.
Thanks, Rod. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you.